The state attorney here in Palm Beach County upped the charges against Robert Kraft and the 24 other men swept up in this investigation to a first-degree misdemeanor. If convicted on those charges, it carries a harsher penalty, including up to 100 hours of classes learning about the evils of human and sex trafficking, as well as up to a year in jail.
This morning, Robert Kraft is back in Boston. The New England Patriots owner seen hugging his star quarterback, Tom Brady, after they flew home from Los Angeles Monday on Kraft's private jet.
We are charging 25 individuals with soliciting another to commit prostitution.
Prosecutors in Florida now charging Kraft with two misdemeanor counts of first-degree solicitation of prostitution.
I can assure you that our office treats everyone the same, whether you have a lot of money or you are indigent, we treat all defendants the same, and no one gets any special justice in Palm Beach County.
Investigators releasing graphic new details of Kraft's two alleged sexual encounters at the Orchids of Asia Day Spa. Everything, police say, recorded on as many as five surveillance cameras. One of Kraft's alleged visits the morning of the AFC Championship game. Detectives say Kraft documented on video engaging in a sex act, handing over a $100 bill and another bill, and then leaving in a chauffeured Bentley waiting outside. If convicted, the billionaire and 24 others named in the investigation could face up to a year in jail. Kraft could also face penalties from the NFL. The organization issuing a statement Monday saying, in part, "Our personal conduct policy applies equally to everyone in the NFL. We will handle this allegation in the same way we would handle any issue under the policy." Kraft's Florida lawyer not responding Monday when asked to comment, but last week a spokesman saying Kraft denied any illegal activity. Now this high-profile case bringing national attention to the issue of human trafficking. The National Human Trafficking Hotline says Florida ranks behind only California and Texas in the number of cases reported, last year receiving more than 14,000 calls nationwide.
This is not about lonely old men or victimless crimes. This is about enabling a network of criminals to traffic women into our country for forced labor and sex.
A lawyer representing other men caught up in this investigation has filed with the court saying that the police videotape, which is key evidence, was obtained legally. Craig, without that evidence, if a court were to decide it was obtained illegally, this case could very well fall apart.